As housing becomes more expensive, we're always on the lookout for ways to make the great Australian dream a reality. Recently, we showed you some wonderful examples of small-scale living. So imagine owning your own home without having to worry about a mortgage. Don't think it's possible? Well, with some clever thinking and brilliant design, believe me, it is possible. From the outside, this is a typical house in the bayside suburbs of Brisbane. Post box, driveway, lock-up garage, looks like a standard four or five bedder. But it's the ingenious design of this place that is going to blow your mind. And it's all the brainchild of Kevin Doodney, the CEO of Future Housing Taskforce.
Hey, hi, Kevin.
I cannot wait to have a look through this.
Come on in.
Beautiful, thank you. This house is configured into five self-contained studio apartments, each with the potential for its own rental income.
So, Jo, welcome to our 42 square metre apartment.
This is great, really generous.
It is, and like all places, you need a kitchen, of course, a bathroom,
yep.
Bedroom, and it's got all of those things.
And heaps of storage.
But what we're really talking about here is just one bedroom. And you know, we've got 12 million vacant bedrooms across Australia right now.
12 million?
Just those four bedroom homes. We just don't use them all.
So how big is this actual block then?
The block here that we've got is only 300 square metres.
Oh, that's tiny.
I know.
These designs comply with most councils because the house keeps its original kitchen, living room and laundry as common areas. So it's technically not seen as an apartment building, but a five-bedroom house with tenants in each bedroom. This idea that the house pays off your mortgage for you, how does that work then?
Well, what we've done is by creating five-bedroom places, in this particular case, you may choose to live in one,
yeah.
But the income from the other four is greater than the actual mortgage cost.
So therefore, you just watch your mortgage go down a hell of a lot quicker. So if we think differently about how we live, we've got the solutions for affordable housing right in front of our very eyes.
Always did have.
Wow. These concepts are used in heavily populated parts of Europe with great effect, and the design choices are endless. But if you are looking at creating a home within a home, then knowing your local council regulations is crucial. And living smaller means living smarter. So Kevin's Display Village is where he shows off all the best ideas in one place.
Welcome into our first lovely apartment. Now, what you're seeing here, Jo,
yeah?
Is a whole different way of how we treat space.
I think maybe because it feels so big, it's got a lot to do with that ceiling height. I mean, it's soaring.
Well, that gives us volumetric space. As an example, these cupboards, you wouldn't normally have such storage capability.
Brilliant. And I guess the other great thing is you have to really think about multifunctional furniture, don't you?
You do. You've got to get those dinosaur room mentalities out.
What do you mean by dinosaur room?
Well, you know, like a dining room is used maybe 10% of the year. Even a bedroom is only used for one third of a day.
Okay.
So why wouldn't you transform that space into other spaces when it's not being used?
I see what you mean. The lounge hides even more storage and your bed.
So with one finger, that just drops down. When you're finished with the bedroom and it's a little bit on the messy side, you don't feel like making it, one finger operation, you simply push it back and hey presto, bed's gone.
I love that. I need that for both my sons.
But we also have to eat.
Yes.
So mirror, mirror on the wall. And all we have to do is create the unlatching. These pull out, drops down, locks in, and away you go.
That's a great size.
Yeah.
And I love the fact that you're using your wall cavity space for extra storage. Can't wait to see what's next.
Well, let's go and have a look.
All right.
Sure. Behind door number two, I call it. We've got a lot more space here. You've actually got 34 square metres of space.
You're kidding. This feels fantastic.
So as we're learning from this particular home, Jo, come and have a look at this, because one of the things we're doing in our next generation of homes is this wall be completely movable.
Oh, wow.
Which then transforms the bedroom space back into our entertainment space.
That is brilliant.
One of the things that really frustrated me from the years of designing homes is this thing with doors.
Yeah.
You get this beautiful climate and you can't really take advantage of it.
Yeah.
So just by adding one more runner, you can actually create double the space.
Doesn't it make a difference to that flow between indoor and outdoors?
Very much so.
I suppose also if you're heading outdoors, you need some motivation.
And we have that. We have our own fridge as you come out onto the deck. Storage spaces underneath our lovely lounge. But the big surprise of all,
ooh,
come with me. That thing that's driven me absolutely mental over the years is that 1.5 metre setback that councils require to the fence line. We've transformed that into a putt-putt.
So what's normally wasted space being turned into a recreation area?
Absolutely.
Yes, I accept the challenge. Thank you, Kevin.
My pleasure. Well, off we go.
Oh, get out of town. Right, I quit. Not on you.
Oh, come on, Joe. Come on, Joe. Give it a go.
That was awesome. Well done.